You do teach through the clarity of your example. So there's a room. We've been describing rooms. So there's a room for you. There's a room mostly filled with people with great misunderstanding of what's going on. And so when you enter a room like that, you have a choice to focus on where they are and give them what they expect, or to focus on where you are and give yourself what you expect. That's an exaggerated example, but that's the tricky thing about your life experience, isn't it? Because you get all tuned in, tapped in, turned on, and then you don't behave the way others expect you to. And then if you're sensitive, you're aware of your misbehaving, but that's when you have a choice to make. Are you going to be what they expect, or are you going to be what you expect? That's the biggest choice of all, isn't it? There's a lot of influence, and law of attraction has been calling it from you. So let's say that you've been practicing this mixed bag, and they all are too. Well, then what they expect is what you're going to give them, because what's active with them is what's active in you, and you'll have no choice. It will just be the natural thing, and you'll be having a step one moment. But what if you're solid in your knowing? What if you're really in alignment with the love that is you? What if you are fearless and knowing and confident? What if you are standing in that stable place? It wouldn't matter what they're doing, because if you've practiced it long enough, you can't just wait till the morning of the funeral and meditate, though. You have to be ready, 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 to be ready. And if you're ready, then don't worry about them, because they're not ready to perceive you as you are. You're not going to bother them.